Okay, what's up, guys?
Welcome back to another vlog. Happy Saturday.
It's Saturday.
The weekend, and I'm already, like, I literally was asking Dave, like, it's already Saturday. That means the weekend's already halfway over.
I know. Just started. Oops.
We need to start our weekends on Fridays. I'm coming, bitch.
I know, I'm ready to go there.
Woo!
But just to fill in what we're doing right now, so we drove out to San Marcos. We're at the Premium Outlets out here. It's like, it's like 45 minutes from Austin.
Yeah.
But if you watched our previous vlog, we went kind of home shopping. We didn't find a whole lot that we wanted, so we thought we'd pop out here because they have like a Williams-Sonoma outlet, Pottery Barn outlet. So we're going to see if we can find anything for the house. And then also, like, there's a bunch of clothes shopping here, so we're going to do that as well.
There's a Pottery Barn outlet here as well. And there's this like day bed that I really want that it takes like 10 plus weeks to get, I think. So I just was like, maybe they randomly have one at the outlet.
Yeah, we're very much in the...
I'm like a very hopeful thinker here, but just thought it would be nice to pop in. Pottery Barn, Williams-Sonoma. What are the other home ones that I sent you? There's only two home ones?
I'm sure there's more.
Maybe some more. It's huge here. We'll have to drive around, see what else they got.
Yeah, so we thought we would drive out here and then we'll very much give like a... Because it's our first time out here, so we'll give like a review of like if it's worth making the drive out here
for sure.
Kind of like what the vibe is. So
for sure,
we're
got the coffee.
We're gonna head into Pottery Barn first and Williams Sonoma because they're right next to each other. So we're gonna do that and bring you guys along. So
see what we can find.
Let's get to it. Excited.
Looks big.
Looks huge. We're in the market for a day bed or something.
In the car, I was saying, like, maybe they randomly happen to have the one we're looking for. This is literally the one we're looking for. Not in this color, but...
Do you like it in person?
It's called the Luna. It's a lot bigger than I thought.
It's huge.
But it's like a day bed that folds out and makes like a queen or king bed or something.
How much is it? So everything is...
40% off, $1,800, I don't know.
Additional 40% off the ticketed price.
I'm
obsessed. Babe, sit in this one.
This? Like,
this is what I wish we had.
Can you sit on our couch?
That one's a good one.
I could sleep with
it. Straight up.
Would you sit in the office?
Hell no.
Oh! Come on. We don't need a desk.
I mean, it'd fit if you wanted to, like, not anything else.
If I was a guest, I would love to sleep on that thing.
For sure.
Right?
It's huge.
Okay.
Let's keep that one on our mind.
Wow.
Let me sit on this Luna thing.
Like when I bent my knee down?
Oh yeah, what the heck?
It's like not comfy, right?
Yeah, it's like hard. Work for guests though.
Oh my god, babe.
Our office is too small for like a normal like queen bed because it's like a hybrid. We use it as an office as well. So we're trying to get them for the guests.
Do you like this style though?
Yeah, I do. Not in the market for a rug, but if you are, this is the place. They're everywhere.
Okay, we made it over to the... It's actually... The Williams-Sonoma is connected to the Pottery Barn outlet. So, we just wandered right on in here. So much good stuff, you guys. Like, I'm overwhelmed. I really was not expecting this at all. Like, I wish I, like, had a better idea of what exactly we needed. We need pretty specific stuff, though. Like... I think we have all the like general basics, but still really fun. A lot of good stuff. Amazing couches.
Okay, so we left the Williams-Sonoma outlet and the Pottery Barn outlet, and we are walking over to the Lululemon outlet. But There's nothing that really, I mean, there's a bunch of things in there that caught our eye. So just nothing that us personally like really loved or needed. But I will say that if you're in the market for home shopping or you're moving or you need to like get a bunch of things, like you gotta go there because yes. It's just the price
or
points are crazy.
Find an outlet near you because like all like the glassware,
yeah,
50% off. Like I don't know, it's just crazy.
So if you're,
if we needed more things, it would have been so nice. But they honestly did have so many couches. Like
yeah.
If we needed a real full size couch, we would have had no problem picking one today.
Right.
Like that one you sat on.
100%.
Oh my god.
I was telling Tay in there. I was like, I wish we would have. When we first moved in the house, I wish we would have went there like
right
immediately, but
well, don't you wonder like okay, now we saw the Luna that I was literally talking about. I was like,
kinda
there's
funny.
No way they're gonna have one, and they totally did. But we sat on it, it was really uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And I don't know if it's because that was like, you know, an outlet one.
Right.
That was like damaged or something, or they're all
I think it was damaged.
Uncomfortable. It didn't seem right.
Yeah.
Like the
it was like folded in a little, right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Didn't seem like it was stuffed or anything.
But anyway, it's so crazy that we saw one.
But yeah, I just thought, like, yeah, like I said, nothing that we personally, like, really, really needed. But if you're in the San Marcos area and, like, are close, like,
yeah.
Definitely worth the trip to go there.
Such a good spot.
But yeah, we're about to head into Lulu, so see what we can find.
Hey, Lulu, I didn't even think it would be, like, a Lulu outlet.
It was the best.
So good.
Lulu
I've never
ever.
Been to a Lulu outlet, I don't think, before. I found this jacket and I'm so bummed because I had a Lulu gift card and I left it at home.
No.
And there's like $100 on it and
yeah.
I couldn't bring myself to buy the $100 jacket without the $100 gift card, so.
Yeah.
Anyways, I didn't get it, but Dame got shorts and they're really cute. Such a cute color. Show them.
Can't wait to work out. I've been needing, this will like kind of finish out my rotation of like workout shorts. I have two black pairs, a blue pair. Then I got kind of this like stone.
Oh, love that.
Tan color.
They have the liner in them like he likes.
Yeah, I always want the liner.
Well, how many inches are they?
This is the 7-inch and it is the
License to Train.
License to Train.
7-inch line.
But I tried them on and they're like super comfortable.
Cute.
Perfect. And I like them because, I don't know, I know this is kind of dumb, but I like them because the liner like sticks out quite a bit. I think it looks cool. It's just like a little cool thing I like.
You're funny.
But
cute, like what, half off of the regular price?
Yeah, like 80 bucks. So
so cute and such a good summer color, I thought.
Yeah, perfect.
Fun.
Perfect.
Well, I'm so hot sweating. We came to the car, I needed some water, and I think we're gonna go.
What,
I don't know where else could we go.
What places would you like?
I want to try that Kirkland Home outlet.
Yeah,
which is down that way.
Okay, I made it to Kirkland Home. West Elm was cute, but not very much stock.
Not our favorite.
Cute little lamps here. Lots of good mirrors everywhere we've been, honestly. We need a mirror for the
I think we need a mirror like once we get like
for the office.
Office or like that wall behind the door downstairs. So you can like last little.
Yeah, when you're leaving.
Yeah.
Cute. I like that. Cute, lots of decor in Kirkland Home. Which is fun. Maybe we could find like a little tray. Food tray, you know?
Okay, we literally had no idea about all these outlets. There's San Marcos outlets, and then there's like Tanger outlets or something that's across the street. So Tanger has Restoration, West Elm, and then, I don't know. But there's way more furniture outlets here than we thought. And look at that couch. Uh-oh.
So many cloud couches, it's crazy. I actually kind of love the gray. Which I feel like would be so comfy for a guest to sleep on, but only for one person. So, that's unfortunate. But if anybody needs a couch, this is it. Oh my god, like I could just stay here and never leave. I don't even care if it takes up the whole living room. I want it. And cute outdoor furniture too. I like this little low to the ground wood set. So cute. They found an outdoor set. This one. Oh my god. Obsessed. Wow.
That's pretty sick.
Cutie.
This is like a good size for our back porch.
Oh my god, yeah. Our back porch is a lot bigger than we thought, and so I feel like our furniture is gonna be pretty small. We did we got our patio furniture yesterday in the mail, so do an unboxing later.
Shall we?
Yeah. Good boy's hungry. I don't remember, but.
Downtown San Marcos. Such a nice day out. It's literally like, what's the temp?
It's gotta be high 80s.
It's cute. We're going to Blue Dahlia Bistro.
Yeah, the downtown lunch. Is kind of a little vibe. It's 85 out right now.
Dang, summertime in Texas.
Wow. But I wasn't expecting like kind of how like there's like a lot of people out and about right now.
Yeah, it's also just a really nice day and it hasn't been in a while, so I'm sure that has something to do with it, but cute little town.
I looked it up before we came here yesterday, and I noticed that the back patio was beautiful, so I'm happy that we got sat back here.
I'm so hungry, the menu sounds so good too. It's like salad, sandwichy, like...
Mediterranean kind of.
Yeah, so, super good.
Are you going to do like wine or beer or something?
Maybe, or make it one like at the next place or something.
Can't decide if I want to, which way I want to go.
Yeah, iced tea sounds really good. It looks fresh brewed too.
Got a mozzarella salad to start.
Yeah, this is like a vegan walnut basil pesto.
That's a vegan walnut basil pesto? Mm-hmm. Yum.
Yum. Oh my god. I could literally eat this with the stone.
It looks nice and fresh.
So good.
So satisfying.
Oh my god, whatever we had was so good. So cute, inside, outside, adorable.
Yeah, I would highly recommend if you're ever in the San Marcos area.
I know, so niche, but if you're ever in San Marcos, so cute. And really good food.
Super good food, and I would recommend sitting in the back patio if you can. It's such a vibe back there. It's a little shaded, which is nice.
If it is too hot, the inside's really cute too, so.
Yeah, 10 out of 10. I think we're gonna head back into Austin right now and see what we can get into when we get back home. So
maybe find a patio out there.
Give you an update soon.
Step. Got my June shine. It's so hot today, it's crazy. But this is our little backyard downstairs. So up there is our where we're always out having wine and breakfast and whatever. And then this is the downstairs. You just come out the like front door to get here. So we have a little patio, a little yard. This is where our storage closets are that we keep like the paddle boards and stuff in. But yeah, there's a little plug up there. We can hang a TV. We gotta get someone over here to do this yard for us. Yeah, look at that overgrowth.
I think they're coming on the 17th, which is Monday.
Okay, cool. But we ordered an outdoor set and I'm so excited. We're about to unpack it, see what it looks like. We've had our eye on this for a while and we figured it's like perfect patio weather right now. So I'm gonna take advantage.
It's from where?
I forget. I need to look it up. I'll definitely link it. But I forget where we ordered it from. The Sava Via something, I don't know. You see this brand everywhere, but you can get it multiple different stores. So anyways, it's a 5-piece set, 4 chairs and a little table. This patio is like pretty big, so it will honestly look a little small.
That's okay.
Out here, but we'll just supplement with more.
Yeah.
And more. It's our old couch that we just threw back here that actually takes up quite a big chunk, but we should probably get rid of that. Anyways, let's crack the June shine open and unpack this thing.
Thank you.
right?
Yeah, they're pretty comfy.
I love them. Fun, guys.
Have a little dinner out here.
Yeah, it's like a almost like a fake wicker, but it looks really good in person. I was nervous because I kind of read that review online.
What did the review say?
That it's actually plastic, not like real, you know.
Uh-oh.
Wicker, which the plastic is so nice because you can just like spray it down, obviously.
Yeah.
Keep it really clean. I'm glad we went without any like cushiony anything. I think that just gets really hard to clean, especially because it's like, I mean, we have a ceiling, but
right,
it's not so protected. Yay! Play cards out here?
Cards, drinks.
I love it. We're gonna have to get a TV.
I know, huh?
Up here. Cool. I'm really happy with it. Are you?
I am. I like what?
The chairs are so comfy. And like, they literally just fold out. Didn't even have to put them together.
I know, that when I saw you pull it out, I was like, oh, thank God.
So good.
Can you hand me the June shiny?
Of course.
First sip at the new table.
Exciting, I can't wait for Brandon and Michaela to come over.
Yeah.
Cute, guys. I'll be sure to link it.
Okay, what is going on, guys? Ooh, that's bright. We are getting ready to go to this place called El Alma. It's like a little Mexican restaurant. To grab some margs, grab some food, and just kind of chill and hang. But I'm making my little pregame slash pre-dinner cocktail, so I thought I'd share it. I've been loving this Empress 1908 gin. Don't let the color throw you off, it's super good. And then just doing a little tonic water, and then just throwing a little bit of rosemary in there. So basically a gin and tonic, but I just add the rosemary. I don't know why, it just kind of tastes good. It gives it a little like, I don't know, herby feel. But yeah, so I'm gonna make that real quick and then wait for Tay to finish getting ready. Oh, and also we're putting it in our new glasses, which we love. Two of these kind of whiskey ice cubes. Tonic. Usually do like half a can, a couple pieces of rosemary. It's so good.
Woo! Gonna show you guys.
Tell them your pregame cocktail.
My pregame cocktail is a June Shine Mango Daydream.
Pre-dinner cocktail.
Pretty good. Just got dressed, show you guys my outfit. Also, I'm obsessed with our new glassware. Okay, I am wearing the same Zara pants I was wearing earlier. The ones with the super cute side stripe. I have been wearing these nonstop. They're so good and so comfy. I wear them low rise most of the time, so they go like to the floor, and then I can wear them with like a sneaker or a flip flop. And then I put this new Zara top on.
I like that top.
If you can see this. But it's like that, it's almost like shirt material. Little tube top, not tube top, strapless. It zips up in the back. It's so adorable. It's just like a little dressier than like your average, yeah, like, I don't know, just like t-shirt, but I love it. I'm wearing my pearl earrings, and then I don't know if I'm gonna do sneakers or flip-flops. I can't decide, but so hot out today. It feels so good. So excited to go sit on a patio.
I know.
But yeah, that's the fit of the night.
Okay.
Let's use more ice. June Shine is so much better over ice, I think. Whoa.
Yeah.
Do you agree? What are you wearing?
I wasn't wearing the same thing I was wearing earlier, but then I saw you. I was like, I should probably change.
I was so sweaty.
Yeah, no, we took a shower after we made our table.
I mentioned white.
Got rejuvenated. But yeah, I am wearing this Elwood oversized tee, just the white one. I got on my Elwood hat just for a little color, and then I got on, oh, let me get the light side.
Oh my God, this thing already broke. I just want to cut them off. What do you say?
And then I got on my new carpenter shorts that
I'm
bought the other day.
Obsessed.
They're from this brand called Profound, which I'm liking a lot of their stuff lately, but they have like kind of like this painted splattered on them. little fun little detail. But
fun.
Yeah.
Should we make a TikTok together?
Yeah, let's do it. I'm down to make a TikTok.
Okay, made it to El Alma. We've never been here before, but it's kind of like a Austin classic, I guess. Mexican, they have a little outdoor patio. It's cute,
yeah,
it's right on Barton
upstairs.
Springs. Yeah, if patio. Not, there's like plenty of other places.
But
yeah, we can go, so.
I'm excited.
Let's head in. Got a great parking spot.
Yeah, we got so lucky with that.
Yeah. Okay, quick pit stop before our table is ready at El Alma. We got some espressos.
We stopped at a place called Revelry.
It's right on Lamar.
10-minute walk.
It's so cute here. You guys, I'll have to give you the full review later, but
yeah, I'd love to eat here.
We ordered some espressos and we're watching Larson's volleyball game. Volleyball season is back, baby. That's new.
It's your little sister.
That's new. Okay, cheers.
Okay guys, we just got to El Alma. Kind of tucked in the corner.
I do not remember that.
But it's a beautiful night out, so we're not complaining. Have a good out. You guys ordered our drinks.
Yeah.
Can't wait to show you guys those. But
we got chips and salsa.
We got chips and salsa right now, but we got drinks coming. And yeah. Alvary is a great spot. I'm excited to like actually go and eat and have a full experience there. So
what would be great for like events or like make like fun, like exciting dinner, like dinner.
But El Alma right now, I love the vibe here. I do love the inside. I love the upper deck patio they have. I think like view of the city and just like on a nice day, you gotta come here for sure. But we'll definitely give a review on the food and the drinks when they come.
That's the best skinny bar, so we'll see how it is.
I ordered something called like a blood and smoke. It's like, I'm a big mezcal guy, so it's like mezcal and like blood orange. So it sounded kind of good.
Okay, got our drinks. I got a skinny marg. Got the volleyball game still on. We are winning. Dave got a blood orange mezcal drink.
Yeah, it's called blood and smoke, but it's yeah, mezcal, blood orange, some type of like liqueur. I don't know how to express it.
Yummy. Cute. About to try our drinks. They give us some chips and salsa. I like it. I'm digging it. What?
That's good.
It's really good. I don't know
about that. It's my this morning. Tay is on a walk right now, so I'm not sure if she's been vlogging or what. I'm making my coffee right now using the Wandering Bear cold brew that we've been loving lately, and then a little bit of oat milk, and then a very tiny bit of the Alfred's vanilla syrup. But yeah, plan for the day really is, I know when she gets back from her walk, we have a little bit of Sunday cleaning to do. So we have, we're gonna test out our new Shark steam mop that Tay got us. And then after that, I know we were talking about wanting to go to like a cafe, just cause we have some like computer stuff to do. And then, yeah, so
kind of see where the day takes us. It's kind of a Sunday reset, so yeah. But other than that, we're gonna wait for Tay to get home, and then we are cleaning the house.
I'm gonna show you guys the Lululemon shorts I got yesterday. Tay found this new like spot in our house to like outfit check, and I'm kind of into it. But yeah, these are the 7-inch Lululemon shorts I got yesterday. So we'll link them because they're like perfect. So I'd recommend them if you're a dude or a lady trying to find some new workout clothes for your man. But yeah, it's like the stone gray color. So but yeah, we'll link those. Okay, unboxing the new Shark that I was telling you guys about earlier. Put this thing to work. Like, does the floor get wet, or is it like...
I thought it'd be like a little more wet. I don't know. Can you like see if it's wet? Yeah, it's definitely damp.
Oh, okay. We're parked like on a parallel park to like a ledge right now, kind of.
Oh my gosh. Hi, everyone. I don't even think I said hi to the vlog today.
Yeah, when I was vlogging this morning, I was like, I don't know if she's where we're at in the vlog, but good morning, peeps.
No, I filmed some of my morning. I got up, did like the lemon water, the coffee. I made like a good to-do list for the day. Made breakfast, and then I went for a little walk, did my Pilates, came back. And Dame and I got into some cleaning at the house, which the floors like desperately needed.
Yeah.
Honestly, it wasn't as bad as I would expect it to be.
No. What was your review of the steam mop though?
Oh, I love the steam mop, you guys. So we got the Shark steam mop. It was only like $60. I got it from Target, and it's so nice because you don't have to use chemicals. It's just like the hot heat that like cleans the floors.
Mm-hmm.
It works really well. It's double-sided, so like once you do one side, you flip over. I would say for our whole house, I would use 2 pads
It comes with 2 pads.
Yeah, so you're not like dragging stuff around. But it seriously worked so well. The tile, you can like really tell. You can tell when it's like getting wet and steamy. The hardwood floors, it's harder to see, but it definitely worked really well. We did the whole stairs. We did downstairs concrete, upstairs hardwood, and all the bathroom tiled floors, so.
Yeah, it went really well.
I like it. Good.
But yeah, really just kind of like spending the morning kind of crossing our T's, dotting our I's, getting everything together.
Prepping for the week.
Yeah, it's always good to like kind of have kind of like that time on Sunday to like get straight and straighten all your stuff just so you go into the week not all over
mumble
the place.
Jumbled. Yeah. I know for me it affects my week so much if I don't like take the time to do that. So I ordered groceries, planned our dinners, that's on the way. Made a list of some things I want to get done today before we make dinner and hang out tonight. So we are actually about to head into the Grove Wine Bar, and figured we would just bring our laptops in there and get a little lunch, hang out, have a little date on the patio outside, do some of the work that I had on my list.
It's in West 6th area.
Yeah, right on West 6th.
It's our first time going in here, so we'll be sure to like let everyone know what the vibe is.
Give the review. It's very much not a West 6th vibe. Like West 6th is like where all the
party bachelor
like Sunday
parties.
Fun day bars are. Yeah. But this is like a total wine bar. I think it's up a few floors.
Yeah,
right?
It looks like it's part of like almost, it looks like an office building almost. So
we are a little early.
They don't open until 4. It's 3:50 right now. So
we stopped at Trader Joe's.
Mm-hmm.
Thought I would share some of our Trader Joe's favorites. I got my all time fave hot and sweet jalapenos.
We're addicted to those.
Had to restock on those. Dame got his. Oh, what flavor did you get?
I got two different kinds of foosballs that I always have before I work out. This one I haven't tried actually. It's the chocolate hazelnut, so I'm just gonna try that one. And then I got the OG peanut butter and jelly that I always have. And then I got two protein bars that I love. So this is the Barbells brand. The cookies and cream especially is my favorite. And then this new flavor, chocolate dough, I'm gonna try. But the Barbells brand is legit. Like if you're ever looking for a protein bar,
a lot of people recommended these. I love these. We used to have like one of these every morning with our coffee.
Espresso beans.
Chocolate covered espresso beans. So good. Restocked the everyday seasoning. This is such a good one for like if you're just being lazy. Love it.
Drench it in that stuff.
Yeah. You know me. And then I got my favorite garlic stuffed olives. I always buy them at Trader Joe's because they're so much cheaper here than anywhere else. Everywhere else they're like $8 a can. Or a jar. Jeez. Crazy. Dame got some Urban Spice popcorn.
This was just like an impulse buy. I don't know why.
We're hungry. We are hungry.
Well, I was thinking ahead. I was like, man, if we watch a show, we need some like popcorn or something tonight. So I was like,
totally.
Throw it in a bowl later.
I also had to get these because people keep trying them on like YouTube and TikTok and everything. So yeah. I'm also just starving. So we had to get them.
I don't know how it is on like every other Trader Joe's, but I feel like most of them, they have like that, when you're waiting in line, they have like that aisle and they're just like,
I get at least three things.
They like, always have like the best snacks and it's like they put it there on purpose. Cause that was literally the last thing at the end. We're like, should we get these? Like,
we had to.
But it's funny cause you see people in line and everyone's just like,
doop. Yeah, so good.
There is. But yes.
Should we try it now or should we try it later?
Let's try it. Yeah. Give one a whirl. Cheers. That's fire. Holy fuck.
Oh my god.
That's so good.
Oh my god. Oh my gosh. Okay. 12 out of 10. Oh my god, babe.
10 out of 10 for sure.
Am I just hungry?
I think you're just hungry.
I'm so hungry.
This place we're going into, I mean, they have like charcuterie boards and stuff, so we'll definitely gonna get one of those. Are you gonna do like red or white?
Hmm?
Are you gonna do red wine or white wine?
It depends on what's on the menu. If I find something that I'm like,
I might do red. I was thinking I'd do white because it's like summery sunshine out right now, but probably end up doing red.
I don't know if I shared, but I bought the Aveline white wine this week. Tried it, love it. I've been wanting to try it for a while. Aveline is by Cameron Diaz. It's her wine brand. They were red, a white, and a rosé, and they're all organic grapes. So I've been wanting to try it for a while. I had Dame pick me up the white, and we tried it, and it's so good.
Yeah. Yeah, well,
I love it. It's like under $20 a bottle. It tastes good, light, fresh. And I'm not really a white wine person. So for me to like it was like everything.
Okay, we're about to head in here, though. We have like a few minutes till they open, so
bring you in. Cute. Got a little patio spot.
Honestly,
like, garden views. Love it here, huh? Yeah. First one's here. Little fit check. I'm wearing these, like, I don't know, Amazon. These are from my friend. Glasses. My black blazer, white crop, Levi's, and black Havaianas.
I got on some like cheap ass like $10 sunglasses. I don't even know where I got them. I got on my Seagram and Staple hat. I got the black oversized Elwood shirt on, and then I got these like camo pants on, like blue square pants from Abercrombie. Okay, so we went for the Old Vine Red. It is a red blend. And it was a good price point on the menu, I thought.
Yeah.
So.
Got a little bottle. Love the glasses.
Cheersy. Yeah, the glasses are amazing. Like, the lip is so thin. Taste test.
Good.
Yeah, it's good.
Like it?
Yeah.
It's not too sweet.
No, which is what I like. Got our bottle, got our food coming. We got
excited to show you the bruschetta.
Some bruschetta.
So good.
So.
Okay. Love sunshine. Not exactly postinos, but we got a mushroom something. I don't even remember. And we got a pistachio whipped feta and honey. And then we did a little smoked salmon cream cheese. So excited. Which one are you trying first?
Probably the smoked salmon.
Yeah. Let's do it.
Okay, we moved the tables into the shade. We're sweating up a storm. Okay, this music though is kind of a buzzkill. Trying the, which one is this one?
That's a pistachio with feta and honey.
Pistachio with feta and honey.
Okay, that one's amazing. Wow.
Okay, getting some work done. I just got a little bit done, so drink a little glass of wine. Log back on here in a minute.
Land.
We're here for the wine too.
Just got home and gonna unpack some of the stuff. Obviously, our Trader Joe's haul, and we stopped at Target and did our pickup order. We just need house stuff like paper towels, sandwich bags. But Dame ran in and got this little Aveline wine that we love. It's that Cameron Diaz one I was talking about, and it's the white wine made with organic grapes, dry with a touch of citrus, and a crisp, fresh finish. Yum, no added sugar, no artificial colors. Yummy, I really like it. Such a good summer drink. I think we are going to hang out for a little while. I have some videos to edit. And I'm probably make dinner here in a little bit. But otherwise, just been like a pretty nice, productive morning, chill day. So glad we got to get out of the house for a little, have some lunch. Always trying to do like a restock of everything on Sunday, so we're not doing it midweek. Like, I hate running out of like paper towels, toilet paper. I hate running out of that stuff in the middle of the week and having to go to Target. Oh shit. Oh shit. Whoop. So it's nice to do it all on Sunday.
Got it.
And get it done. Groceries first?
Yeah.
That works.
I want to show you guys what kind of what we got going on for dinner tonight. So we have some mushroom, zucchini, and broccoli that I cut up. We're gonna do like a little bun of it all on the side. We're gonna do this wild mushroom and herb rice that we got a little bit while ago, but it'll be our first time trying this, so we'll let you guys know how that is. And then we got like the salmon cut up and marinating right here. So it's kind of the dinner layout for tonight.
Yummy.
Okay, we got the veggies. Veggieing, the salmon going, rice is almost done.
Cheers.
Cheers, babe. It was a good weekend, we did a lot. But that was our little weekend vlog, Sunday reset, kind of. Went out to some fun dinners, checked out San Marcos, so.
Good weekend.
We're gonna end the vlog here, but we'll definitely be vlogging during the week, so it'll be good.
Bring you guys along, maybe some more house updates. I don't know what's going on this week, but we'll keep you updated.
We'll figure it out.
Happy Sunday, love you lots.